So the next thing is for us to come over to the scientist class. This is going to be our model class. Now the model class basically is our data object class, okay? So it actually represents the unit of data that we're going to be working with. For example, this is an app for registering listings and performing CRUD operations on scientists. So a model class will represent a single scientist. So for example, this particular list view, router, or this recycler view is listing for us our scientists, okay? Now each of them will be represented by the scientist class. So for example, if we come and click this one, basically the model class that you're going to create will define for us these properties: the scientist name, description, galaxy, star, date of birth, date of death, etc. Okay, and in fact, if we go over to the editing page, we're still going to pass that scientist object and then set its properties right here within these particular widgets. So that is our model class. Okay, it basically represents the unit of data that we're working with. It's just a simple class, but we have to make it implement the serializable interface. Why are we doing that? Well, because we want to be passing that particular scientist, an object of this scientist class, across activities. Okay, so for us to be able to do that one, we need to either make it parcelable or make it serializable. So we are going to use the serializable interface. Then of course, for example, if I click a single item, we'll be able to just pass a whole scientist across the activity. Basically, we serialize it, then pass it to another activity, then deserialize it, and then render its contents. Again, if I click this one, we again serialize it, pass it to the CRUD page, then deserialize it, and then render its contents. What are those contents? Of course, we have the ID, name, description, galaxy, star, DOB, DOD, and key. So this key, we are annotating it with these two attributes because it's going to be the responsibility of the Firebase real-time database to generate for us the key, okay? All these other data sets will be passed, of course, from the client, but the key will be passed, of course, from our cloud database. Now, when you're using Firebase real-time database, you must have an empty constructor. So that's what we're specifying router. Then, of course, we're also going to have another secondary constructor, which will receive these particular properties, and then we set them to our instance fields. Okay, that's all we're doing. Then, of course, we also override the toString method. Does it, guys? This will make up our scientist.kt. This is our scientist class in Kotlin. Let's move over to our next lesson.